Life is kind of strange, you know. One minute, you're on top of the world, a community college graduate with his whole future ahead of him. Next thing you know, you're on the pot, trying to remember the prayers they taught you in Sunday school so as to ward off the demonic presence in your bowels. It's funny how one spoiled papaya can change everything in the blink of an eye. This is my life. This is my story. I'm Doug Bozerman. Pleased to meet you.
Story, huh? The genesis tale of my hemorrhoids, right? Well, it was 4 years ago, spring break, 2001. It was supposed to be the greatest week ever. You know, it was all about hedonism, debauchery, excessive drinking, casual sex with a different girl every night of the week. I didn't see it coming. I never could have foreseen what was going to happen to me. The same day I arrived, I made the mistake of going to a fruit vendor on the street. Obviously, it wasn't regulated by their government, and even if it was, you know, that wouldn't have made much of a difference. The fact is, I got a hold of a bad papaya. Just, it seemed like a really good idea at the time. I was hungry. It was hot. I had a craving for a papaya. You know, little did I know that papaya was gonna end up ruining my life. For the next 7 days, I was urinating from my butthole. It was horrible. I mean, these hemorrhoids, they cost me my career. I was well on my way to becoming an architect. My dream, my childhood dream of designing buildings, designing bridges and this, my dreams shattered by an ass polyp. The strain that it's put on my friendships, my relationships with other people, it's driven a wedge between me and my closest friends, because this has become such a prevalent issue.
Oh, hold on.
Oh, touchdown! Yeah, in your face! Woo! Oh, no! Oh! Response to my hemorrhoids? Well, obviously they've been very understanding about the whole situation.
Okay, this is the medicine cabinet here. This is what helps me keep the hemorrhoids in check. It's a veritable pharmacy, obviously. My three-pronged approach essentially starts here. I start off with the stool softeners. Obviously they do just that, soften my stool during a bowel movement, make things a little bit easier on the roids during the evacuation. Alright, here's the hydrogen peroxide. Actually, this helps quite a bit during the cleanup, and it also helps prevent infection, which is key.
It's put a severe financial burden on my family. We've racked up in the past 4 years or so, at least $30,000 worth in hospital bills, outpatient treatment, ointments, you name it, the list goes on.
All right, and these are the Epsom salts. What I do with these is I run a warm bath, right, And then I just kind of sprinkle those in there like that. And then I sit in the bathtub and I soak my hemorrhoids, you know, ass cheeks akimbo, and I just let the hemorrhoids absorb all the salts to relax the anal sphincter. And that helps with the spasms and the nerves there.
But they've been there for me. They've been my support system.
And finally we've got the creme de la creme, which is the preparation H. But it's no normal preparation H. This is the prescription strength. This stuff is industrial strength. It'll strip the paint off a Buick, no questions asked. And I can't seem to find.
I consider myself really fortunate to have parents who are willing to go to bat for me in spite of my horrible condition.
And that's not it. If I can just hold on here, I'm not seeing it. Hey, Ma. Ma, where's my ass cream? No, Ma, not ice cream. Ass cream. Ass cream. Rocky Road ass cream! You gotta kind of pry it open, you see that?
You got like a pry bar or something?
No, just put the flashlight in your mouth and use your hands to just pry it open.
Oh God, it looks like something out of Fraggle Rock.
Well, there's actually three of them in there, you see that? They're all kind of, they're just kind of jockeying for position, you know, and there's, and they're vertical, they're right on, one on top of the other. You see how that works? And they're just... It's like they're playing tic-tac-toe or something, you know? Circle gets the square!